Namaste everyone, how are you doing today? Today's video is called How You Can Use Parallel Realities to Shift to an Alternate Universe. So basically, time is not linear how we think that, you know, the past happened, then the present, and then the future's happening. Everything actually exists all at the same time. The past, present, and the future are all in one space-time continuum. What happens is, when we live in this physical reality, we think that everything works in a sequence. However, from source's perspective, from universe's perspective, everything is all at once. And enlightened beings like Buddha, for example, when they did become enlightened, they saw all their lives, their past lives and future lives all at once. And the analogy to explain that would be, you know, you have a projector film that puts projection onto the screen. It usually works with loads of little photographs, and they all spin really, really fast. So when you're close to one photograph, like a film and a camera film, you see the one picture, but if you push it further back, you can see all of the different frames, and that's very similar how everything works all at once. So you have access, literally, if you are aware enough, to your future and your past at the same time. And this is what works with quite a lot of channels who do channeling from other universes and other sort of extraterrestrial beings, which I post on my social media. And they give a wide variety amount of information. But basically what it is, it's the human person who's speaking, who's channeling their future self. It's not an alien, it's their future self who's in a different universe speaking through them. So it's very interesting and it blows your mind. And I will explain why I have decided to talk about parallel Earths and reality today. And the reason for that is very important to explain later. So each of us, each of you, have the ability to tap into a different vibration and therefore into a different reality. How it works is like this. Say you're someone who's a very positive and loving person. You'll attract people who are very positive and loving, and you'll have a wonderful life. You know, if you avoid the media and the fear tactics and all that, you won't experience terrorism, you won't be at the wrong place at the wrong time, you'll be at the right place at the right time. People who are negative, believe in fear, and see all the ISIS and all the craziness on TV, they've got it in their consciousness. So their parallel reality, the vibration frequency they're in, makes them a match to similar circumstances. And therefore, if you change your perspective and increase your vibration, to joy and love, you can interact with people who also vibrate at that frequency, and you basically will interact with a better world. And that is something that people don't understand, that you can choose to basically have a better life by changing the way you feel about yourself and feel good. You have access to this every second, every minute. You know, everything is existing at the same time right now. Your future, your past, and your present, it's all illusionary perspectives. It's just another angle or a way of seeing the present now. That's how you can imagine it. Like, the present now is just a different angle, because to be honest, your future can change according to how you behave right now. So your actions currently can impact that. So there's actually many possible futures, many possible outcomes, many possible parallel realities, depending on what choices you make and how you feel. So becoming aware of the totality of the universe and accelerating your ability to see more of what you are part of will allow you to access the sort of realities you want to access. So basically, you just step up your vibration and you receive more different realities, so you can go to a higher vibration and be able to access all of this. It is currently the new age, which they call the Aquarius age, and this is when we're getting out of the dark, you know, Kaliyuga, and we're going into the light, which is Satyuga. So everything is all happening very, very fast right now. We're kind of getting out of that. So you'll see more negativity, more violence, and more positivity as well, because people are trying to get rid of all the crap and all the venom and all the purging of the Earth's karma, basically. So you'll see a lot of extremities. If you buy into the media and you see all that, you'll experience it as well. So that's why on Earth currently, we're getting a lot of negative, a lot of violence, a lot of polarity, because it's the end of the era of limitation, where humans realize that they are not limited. There's not much time left, so all of this is basically getting purged. You have a choice whether you basically feed into that or you don't feed into that, so you can make that choice today. Different souls have chosen to experience different things, but expansion, even the negativity, is helping them to expand and helping everyone else to realize what they actually do want, to figure out things, and we're essentially trying to move towards more towards love, but with the new vibrations of the planet that will happen naturally. So what I really want you to hold into is that you have the power to manifest the future that you want. Right now, right this present moment, you can decide what kind of path you want your future to be. If you truly feel, think, and basically act according to a particular outcome, it's all possible. If you imagine it, if you have visualization techniques, it's all possible. You can tap into it right now. You just have to be in the vibrational vicinity for a long enough period, which is usually 17 seconds. So when you, the law of attraction works like this. You ask for something, which you do naturally, you always want this or that, and that's natural unconscious as well. And then you if you're consciously doing it, you'll be in that sort of momentum of thinking about it for at least 17 seconds, so it continues. And then you allow, and by allowing, you have to be on a high vibrational, like happy and joy in order for it to happen. Because when you are negative and sad, you're thinking about the lack of having that thing. Say, for example, you want a relationship and you're upset and down. That's not how you would feel if you're in a relationship. When you're in a relationship, you feel full, you feel complete. So you've got to feel as though you already are and in a relationship and you're already feeling that way. So you ask what you want, which you're doing anyway. You allow it, and then you allow it basically. And it's given to you eventually. So with regards to Brexit and the EU referendum in the UK, example, a lot of you, well, half of the country are upset about the outcome. So if you want the best outcome for the country, I would suggest asking the universe for the best possible outcome and then allowing it to happen by visualizing it and also being happy and positive. I don't suggest that you ask for the UK to remain part of the European Union, because you don't know if that is actual, if it's for the higher good of the country. Say, for example, the European Union in 5 or 10 years time collapses, or this major terrorist disaster or whatever there is, maybe we've been saved. The universe knows far more, the higher self knows far more than we do. So simply asking for the best possible solution from the universe and allowing that to happen by thinking positively can be the best sort of activism that you can do. You can empower yourselves and empower your leaders and your governments by acting from a place of love and removing fear from yourself. So stop watching the news and the media, stop getting into that craziness because they like to, you know, perpetuate that, and come from a place of love, because then you'll be able to manifest. You know, when you're looking at the current reality of what they're telling you, all the negative bad, 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 you're just sowing the seeds of negativity in the future. If you're all confused and anxious, then that's what's going to happen. So come from a place of love and vibrate that out, because you have to remember that you are the revolution and you can bring change to this planet with every thought and every feeling and every visualization and everything that you put out there. So be loving to one another, be positive, and know that everything's going to work out wonderfully. Get on those high vibrations, and therefore you will have a parallel reality existence with people who also have a loving, high vibrational sort of energy. You'll have the best life of your dreams. You won't stress or worry because you know that the universe is protecting you and everything's working out for your highest good, and you're just going to swim through life and you have the best life ever, and everything that you want is going to just happen synchronistically, just get attracted to you. So I just want you to remember that and really research this as well. If you go onto Abraham Hicks and Bashar on YouTube, you can really find out more about, you know, the law of attraction, how the mind works. And I always post it on my social media, which I would love for you to subscribe to. Subscribe to my newsletter on my website, myspiritualsoul.com. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. And those who subscribe have a chance for winning my book, Bollywood Gay, out this summer. Like, comment, and share this video. The more we get it out there, the more people will realize that actually you have the power to change things with the way you think. And let's give out positivity and let's give out love to the world, because that's how we're going to heal. Thank you very much. Have a good week.